For years, we've been reporting about the impact of forever chemicals on Minnesotans.
Much of that PFAS contamination is linked to 3M, which is paying out billions of dollars to help clean it up. Well, last month, the Minnesota Pollution Control Agency showed us where PFAS is expected to spread and their plan to slow it down.
Tonight, Richard Reeve reports on what it means for your health and the effort to get your drinking water cleaned up.
PFAS chemicals, an invisible threat to our drinking water supply.
PFAS is a forever chemical. It will be in our aquifers for centuries.
And that has Minnesotans, especially those in the East Metro, voicing concerns, like at this public meeting in Hastings earlier this month.
Or are you saying we're supposed to buy distilled water from Walmart?
But officials struggle to give an answer. The Centers for Disease Control says long-term exposure to PFAS is linked to kidney and other cancers, hypertension during pregnancy, increased cholesterol, and other issues. But at what level does your tap water become a health concern?
It takes years to accumulate in your blood some of these PFAS.
Christine Close, a Minnesota Department of Health toxicologist, says those health problems do surface, but after years of daily consumption of PFAS contaminated water.
We can't exactly say whether it's 10 years or 5 or 15 or 20, because the concentrations are different and we don't have that data per concentration or dose.
Close says kidney cancer, for example, is triggered after what she calls a lifetime of exposure. But she says families just starting out should be especially vigilant.
If you have a child or young children or you're pregnant and you have an infant in the home, then you might want to consider getting treating your water.
Several municipalities in the East Metro are spending millions to build plants to filter out PFAS chemicals from the commercial water supply. But those could take years to build. In the meantime, if you have concerns, the health department recommends home filtering systems you can install on a faucet, under a sink, or at a point of entry to protect the entire house.
Those solutions right now consist of a carbon filter, which is called a GAC filter. Reverse osmosis works as well, and also what something that's called ion exchange. But all three of those work to eliminate the PFAS family of chemicals down to levels where we cannot detect.
But efforts to get rid of PFAS in our water are already hitting a hurdle. Just last month, regulators announced new limits for PFAS in a city or community's water supply. The MPCA listed these 22 water systems as exceeding the 4 parts per trillion limit. Among them, Hastings, Sauk Rapids, and Woodbury, which requested millions in state funding to help with construction of water treatment plants, new wells, or storage facilities. But the end of the legislative session without passage of a bonding bill means no state money. City staffers there are planning to build 3 treatment plants at a cost of nearly $69 million, and now they're scrambling to find funding.
But the biggest thing that we're starting to realize is we may have to look at our own ratepayers. And so we have a workshop coming up next month where we're going to have some of those hard conversations about what would happen to our water rates here in Hastings to be able to fund the required improvements to provide safe and clean drinking water to our community.
Now, Hastings officials say they're also considering building a single treatment plant instead of 3 to save money, with the idea of finding additional funding in the future for the rest. Now, Stemsky says with the money in place, the entire project could be done in about 3 years, Lindsay.
All right, Rich, thank you so much.